Hello everyone, welcome to the Java course. When we create classes, we build the classes by using the primitives. Actually, we can also build other classes by using some of our user-defined classes. Let us see an example. I have a shirt class and a trousers class. And in the shirt class, I have a lot of instance variables, and I also provide the constructor, and also I have some accessors and mutators. I have only accessors from the shirt class. And in the trousers class, I also have some private instance variables and the constructor. I also have some accessors for my trousers class. If I want to create another class called uniform class, I need to combine the shirt class and the trousers class. So how can I make use of these two classes to create another user-defined class? We can try it now. In the uniform class, I can simply use the shirt data type as part of the components of the uniform class. So shirt is actually becoming a part of the class decoration of another class. So a shirt class is used in another class called uniform. And here I simply want to declare an instance variable called shirt type. And this instance variable is of shirt type. That means it is storing the reference of a shirt object. Same for the trousers. I can create another reference variable which points to an object of trousers type. So the instance variables for the uniform class are simply two reference variables that point to each of the shirt and trousers objects. For now, I haven't created the actual objects because I haven't used the new keyword yet. How can I make use of the new keywords to create uniform objects? I need to make use of the constructor. Okay, this is a very long parameter list. I simply want to combine all the parameters for each of the objects. For the shirt object, I simply provide all the private instance variables of the shirt class. So S here means shirt. So I have shirt color, shirt size, shirt cost, and the Boolean variable that indicates whether the shirt is having long sleeves or not. And for trousers, I have two private instance variables. One is called T size and the other is called T cost. T here means trousers. So I have two instance variables from the trousers class to indicate the size and the cost. Okay, here I create the shirt object by using the new keyword. So now shirt type is really having the reference content, which points to a shirt object. And the parameters of the shirt object are obtained from the uniform constructor. Okay, I do similar things for the trousers type reference variable. Now the trousers type variable is now storing the reference to a trousers object whose parameters are provided by the uniform constructor. Now I create a method pertaining to the uniform class. So this method is something new. We don't inherit any of the methods from the shirt class or from the trousers class. The idea is like this. Okay, in order to find out the total cost of a uniform, we have to know the shirt price together with the trousers price. So how can I get the cost of these two components? I make use of the accessor methods provided by the shirt class. And the accessor provided by the trousers class. Because the cost of the shirt and the cost of the trousers are set to be private here and private there, I must rely on the accessors provided by the shirt class and by the trousers class in order to get the cost. I don't access the object context directly. I have to rely on the getter methods provided by the shirt class and the trousers class. Okay, that is the uniform class. Let me save it. And now I can go back to the driver class. If I want to create a set of uniforms, I can use the ordinary object creation approach. Okay, Amy is simply an employee of a company who would wear the uniform, and Amy's uniform is having this configuration. Red means the shirt color, 20 means the shirt size, 10 means the shirt cost, and false means that the shirt is not having long sleeves. And 25 here means that the trouser size is 25. 15 is the trousers cost. If I want to get the cost of the uniform for Amy, I can do something like this. Okay, I call the method from the uniform class, which gives me the total cost of the full set of uniform for Amy. Let me run it now. There's an error. Let me see. Oh, here I got the typo. B-O-O-L-E-A-N. Let me try again. I get the answer 25. Why 25? Because I simply add up the cost of the shirt with the cost of the trousers. So I would have 10 plus 15, which would give me 25. So in this case, the total cost of a set of uniform is obtained by using the get total cost method from the uniform class. So after this illustration, I hope you're able to understand that we can create other classes by means of our classes created previously. So in my example, a uniform is created by using the shirt class and the trousers class, and in the uniform object it has two pieces of data. One is the shirt type reference variable, and the second one is the trousers type reference variable. And for the reference variables, each reference variable would point to the appropriate object. So the shirt type would point to the shirt object, and the trousers type would point to a trousers object. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, feel free to leave your comments on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.